Good morning, dear children. Yes, here we are back in our physics class. All of you are ready, right? So we are dealing with motion in the last class. Let's continue the session. One instruction to you, dear children. Don't open your textbook. You have to keep your textbook closed and listen to the teacher, okay? Let's start. Yes, motion. We are continuing with motion. Last class, we have studied about two physical quantities to describe motion, distance and displacement. Here, this picture listen, children. Here you can see a ball moving through a horizontal surface, a plane surface. It is moving, is it? Yes. It starts from here. So we can take this point as the origin. Origin. Do you remember origin? Reference point, starting point. Yes. This is the origin. And the ball moved from the origin. And after 1 minute, so here we can take the time also zero. Time cannot be zero, but the starting time you have to note it as zero, okay? So from zero time, when we look at the ball, it moves. And after 1 second, it has completed 10 meter. So 10 meter is the distance traveled by the ball in 1 second, right? Yes. Then the ball continue its motion and it moves from this position to this position in the next 1 second. That is, now the distance, the time taken is 2 seconds. So after 2 seconds, the ball is here and the total distance is 20 meter. So here, 1 second to 2 seconds, the time interval between is 1 second. And in that time interval, it has traveled a distance of 10 meter. Again, when we observe the ball, from that 2 second to 3 second, that is, again the time interval is 1 second, and the ball has traveled 10 meter. So here also 1 second, 1 second. So what is the peculiarity in this movement of the ball, in this motion? Yes, equal time interval, 1 second. In 1 second, the ball has traveled 10 meter. The next 1 second, 10 meter. So it covers equal distance. So equal distance is covered by the ball in equal intervals of time. In equal intervals of time. So we can call the motion of the ball uniform motion. What? Uniform. Uniform motion. So how can we say that the ball is in uniform motion? Yes. The ball covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. So the ball is in uniform motion. Then if it travels unequal distance, imagine a car moving in a crowded road, then it cannot travel equal distance in equal intervals of time. So we call the motion non-uniform because the distance traveled is not equal, unequal. Let us see that non-uniform motion with another example. So here, uniform and non-uniform motion. Uniform and non-uniform motion. Here the distance traveled by two objects, A and B, is given. Let us see the motion of A. So in a time 9:30, the distance traveled by the object A is 10 meter. Then by 9:45, it has traveled 20 meter. So what is the time interval here? Time interval is 15 minutes. So within 15 minutes, it has traveled 10 meter. Again, at 10 a.m., object A has traveled 30 meter. So, again the time interval is 15 minutes and the distance traveled is 10 meter. Here also, when you check 10, 15, 40 meter. So, everywhere within the same interval of time, the object have traveled same distance. So, the motion of A is uniform. We can say the motion of A is uniform. Then, look at C. Sorry, look at B. The object B, it has traveled 12 meter in the beginning, 9:30 a.m. And after 15 minutes, the distance is 19. That means 7 meter in the first 15 minutes. Here the time interval is same. And after the next 15 minutes, it has traveled 23 meter. That is the difference is, yes, 4 meter. Again, 23 to 35. What is the difference? It is, yes, 23, then 12 meter has traveled 12 meter. Look, children, here the distance traveled varies. Distance traveled is not same in the same interval of time. So, we can say that the object B is in non-uniform motion. So, how can we say that object B is in non-uniform motion? The object B travels unequal distance in equal intervals of time. Okay. So, here we can see examples for uniform motion. Look at this. Here, our Earth, our blue planet, Earth, is moving around the sun, the superpower, super energy source, ultimate source. So, Earth is moving around the sun. It travels equal distance. Earth travels equal distance in equal intervals of time. So, revolution of the Earth around the sun is an example for uniform motion. Here, the hands of a watch or a clock, it executes uniform motion. And the rotation of Earth about its own axis. Earth rotate about an imaginary axis. And the rotation is an example for uniform motion. Again, you can see a train moving through a straight path. So, when moves through the straight path, straight line path, the object will not change its speed. That is, when moves in a straight path, it covers equal distance in equal intervals of time. So, the train moving with the same speed through a straight path is an example. Train or car or bus, any vehicle. It's an example for uniform motion. Clear? Yes. Now we can see some examples for non-uniform motion. Yes. Here, an aeroplane. Aeroplane, before takeoff, it moves through the runway. When it moves through the runway, it increases its speed. Then again, its speed increases and it moves with a large speed. So, here when it moves through the runway, the speed changes. That is, it covers unequal distance. The distance covered is not equal in regular intervals of time. So, it covers unequal distance in equal intervals of time. Then, when we throw a ball upwards, what happens? Earth is pulling it down, right? So, due to that gravitational force, the ball decreases the speed. That is, due to the gravitational force, the distance traveled by the ball will not be equal in equal intervals of time. So, this is also example for non-uniform motion. Yes. Here, this is familiar to you. Last class we have seen this. That is, a pendulum. A pendulum moves to and fro about its mean position. What happens then? Yes, at this position, the pendulum cannot stop there. It comes back and its speed increases. It covers more distance in a particular time. So we can say that the motion of a pendulum is also non-uniform because it travels unequal distance in equal intervals of time. So these are the examples for uniform and non-uniform motion. Clear, children? Now we can define, we can see the definition of these two types of motion, and here you get two questions, board pattern questions. Very nice questions which can be there in your question paper. It's board pattern question. The definition, define uniform motion and define or define non-uniform motion. So uniform motion and non-uniform motion. A body is said to be in uniform motion if it travels equal distance in equal intervals of time. A body is said to be in non-uniform motion if it travels, yes, unequal distance in equal intervals of time. It is clear for you, right? Yes, we can move to the next topic. Is it? So, we are now describing motion. Is it, children? Yes, we are describing using some physical quantities and we have studied distance and displacement. Now we are going to see the rest of the physical quantities and we want to measure the rate of motion. Rate. So look here, what you can see? You can see a signboard, right? You are familiar with this, wherever we can see this. And 20, we need to measure. So here 20 kilometer per hour you have seen. And here 70 kmph, that is 70 kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour. So here, number of kilometers traveled in 1 hour. Number of kilometers traveled in 1 hour. So we are measuring the rate of that motion, rate of that movement, how many kilometers have covered in 1 hour, in a particular interval of time. So we have to measure the rate of motion, and this rate of motion is called the next physical quantity to describe the motion, speed. Speed is a distance traveled by an object in a particular interval of time. So, we can measure speed as the distance traveled in unit time. So, speed is equal to distance divided by time. Speed is a distance traveled in unit time. So speed is equal to distance by time. That is the rate of distance covered by an object. So here you have seen the speed is expressed in kilometer per hour. Here also 70 kilometer per hour is a speed limit. So we can express the speed with that unit. So distance has got a unit kilometer. Lot of the SI units are there for distance. And time has got so many units. So when we take kilometer, then the unit of time, you have to take hour. Then time has got the unit kilometer per hour. But the SI unit, the SI, what is the SI unit of distance? Yes, the SI unit of distance you have learned in the last class, it is meter, and the time, the SI unit is second. So meter by second, small letter m and small letter, yes. So meter by second, or you can write it as meter per second, it is also meter by second, or m s raised to minus 1. S raised to minus 1 is what? 1 by s. So m by s, you can write as m s raised to minus 1. You have to read it as meter per second. Clear? Yes. So speed. Speed is denoted by the letter, small letter v. Then speed v is equal to distance. In mechanics we are expressing distance, notating the symbol for distance is S. Capital S you can take. and time is represented by small t. So the equation is v is equal to s by t. Our equation for speed is v is equal to s by t, and the SI unit is meter per second. And the speed has magnitude only, it has no direction. So what we call that physical quantity which has only magnitude? Yes, it's a scalar quantity. So speed is a scalar physical quantity. Clear? So speed is to determine the rate of motion, rate of distance travel. So the distance traveled in unit time is speed, and speed is equal to distance divided by time. And we have the equation small v is equal to s by t, and SI unit, system international or standard unit of speed, is meter per second. It is a scalar quantity. And from this equation v is equal to s by t, we can calculate speed. Then if we want to calculate the distance travel, we will take s is equal to, we have v is equal to s by t. So if we want s, keep s there and take t to the other side, then you have to multiply and you will get v into t is equal to s. So s is equal to v into t, velocity into time. And if you want t, what will you do? T, you want t, you take t to this side, then t is equal to take v to the other side, s by v. So t is equal to s by v. Time taken is equal to distance divided by speed. Distance divided by speed. So we have the definition for speed and the unit of speed, and three equations we have. Here, suppose the object is in non-uniform motion, the distance traveled varies with time, then what we have to do? That is the total, the total distance varies, the distance varies with time. If the distance varies with time, that is a body is in non-uniform motion, how will we calculate speed? There you have to take the total distance covered by the body divided by the total time taken, that is average speed you have to take. You have to take the average speed. So average speed is equal to total distance divided by total time taken. Clear, children? Okay, so we have done one of the physical quantity which determines the rate of motion, which gives the rate of motion. Is it clear for you? Yes. Then we need to measure speed. So we want a device. You are familiar with the devices we use in our automobiles to measure speed, is it? So here we have two devices. One is the speedometer and the other is the odometer. So speedometer and odometer. What is the difference between the speedometer and odometer? Speedometer, here in this picture you can see a speedometer. Are you able to see this? Yes, here 0, 20, 40. Then if the needle is towards 40, you will say that the vehicle, the automobile, the car is moving with 40 kilometer per hour speed. Is it? So this 40 kilometer per hour, it measures, it gives the speed directly in this device. And this is the speedometer, speedometer. And in the case of odometer, odometer, if you can see that 0, 1, 2, 3 likewise. Odometer gives a distance, the miles travel. So the miles travel is given, that is a distance traveled is given, and we have to analyze the distance and calculate using distance by time, and we will get the speed. So odometer gives the distance and we have to calculate the speed, but speedometer gives the speed directly. That is the difference between these two devices to measure speed. Clear? Then we are going to discuss types of speed. I already told you that the speed, the distance traveled, changes with time. So when the distance traveled changes with time, we have to measure speed by taking the average speed, and the average speed is equal to total distance by total time, and it is also expressed in meter per second. Practically we use the unit kilometer per hour, but the SI unit is meter per second, SI unit. So in our syllabus we need to express all the physical quantities in SI units, but practically most probably we use kilometer per hour for measuring speed. So that is the first type, average speed. Next, uniform speed. Now I think you are able to define that uniform speed. What is uniform speed? Yes, if the distance traveled is uniform, if the distance traveled is same in equal intervals of time, same as the uniform motion. So if object travels equal distance in equal intervals of time, equal distance in equal intervals of time, then uniform speed, and definitely that object will be in uniform motion. Clear? Then non-uniform speed. So if the object travels unequal distance in equal intervals of time, it's moving with non-uniform speed, and it with the motion will be non-uniform. So same definition for uniform speed and uniform motion, non-uniform speed and non-uniform motion. Then this is a new term for you, instantaneous speed. So I told you that the car moving through a crowded road, the distance traveled by the car is not same in equal intervals of time. So at a particular time, that is 10:10, what is the speed of the car? So the speed at an instant, at that particular instant, is called instantaneous speed. So speed at any instant is called instantaneous speed. Speed at any particular time is called instantaneous speed. So these are the types of speed: average speed, uniform and non-uniform speed, and instantaneous speed. You just keep this in mind. Now, in our numericals, I told you practically we measure the speed in kilometer per hour. But we need to express the speed in SI unit. So we want to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second. You know how to convert it. Then also I am brushing up. Here 50 kilometer per hour is given. You know that 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter, and 1 hour is equal to 60 seconds. Small s you have to write for second. Then 1 kilometer, here 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter by 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes, then 60 into 60 seconds. When you divide 1000 by 3600 and you get a fraction 5/18. Okay, so here 54 kilometer per hour, it is easy to convert 54 kilometer per hour into meter per second. So you have to just multiply 54 into 5 by 18, because already we have converted and reduced it to a small fraction. So to convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, multiply with 5 by 18. If you want to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour, you multiply by 18 by 5, the reciprocal. So here you have to keep this in mind. To convert kilometer per hour to meter per second, multiply with 5 by 18. Then what will you get? 18, 3. 3s are 54. So 3 5s are 15 meter per second is the answer. So one more I am going to give you. 90 kilometer per hour is 90 into 5 by 18. That is equal to 18 into 5. So 5. 18 and 5 if you cancel, don't cancel like this. 5 into 5, don't do this cancellation in our physics notebook or physics answers. You have to just move to the right side and do it. 5 into 5, 25 meter per second is the speed. So in this way you have to convert. So when we deal with numericals, you have to do that, okay. So here we can do the numerical. A train moving with uniform speed covers a distance of 150 meter in 5 seconds. Calculate the speed of the train and the time taken. So time taken to cover 240 meter. So here what is the distance given? So first you have, when you get a numerical, you have to read the question and write the data given. So here distance is 150 meter and the time taken to cover that distance is 5 seconds. So you are asked to calculate what? Yes, speed. So what is speed? You have to write the equation, distance divided by time. Is it? Then substitute, that step is very important. Distance is 150 divided by time is 5 seconds. When you cancel this, you will get 330. It is 30. Then speed has got the SI unit, meter per second. Don't forget to write the unit. Unit is very, very important. You will, your mark will be reduced by half. Half of your mark will be reduced if you fail to write the SI unit. So 30 meter per second. And one more question is there. The time it takes. So here it is time it takes, it is correct. So time it takes to cover 240 meter. So time taken, you need to calculate the time taken. Time t is equal to, I have given you one equation. Time t is equal to s by v. Time is distance by velocity. So what was the distance here? 240. So the question is the time taken to cover 240 meter, right? So here the distance is 240 and divided by speed we have calculated in the earlier session. Speed was 30 meter per second. So 240 by 30. Then when you cancel, you will get 8 second is the time. Okay. So speed is equal to distance by time. There we have calculated. In the first session we have calculated V is equal to S by T. And you have substituted 150 by 5. That is equal to 30 meter per second. And with the same speed, you have to calculate the time taken to cover 240 meter. So time is equal to again distance by speed. Then substituting this distance and the speed is same. With that same speed it has to cover. So it is 8 seconds. So this is the way of doing or measuring, calculating speed. We can do so many other numericals in the coming classes. Okay, don't worry. So here I have given one more question. Speed of a car is 36 kilometer per hour. Express it in meter per second. It is very simple for you. I hope you have a paper or a book in front of you. You can do it yourself. So what is given? Speed is equal to 36 kilometer per hour. How will you convert, children? 36 into, yes, 5 by 18. Then 10 meter per second. This is the answer, is it? So we have studied speed and we know how to calculate speed. So we have seen uniform motion, non-uniform motion. Uniform speed and non-uniform speed is same as this. And speed is the distance traveled in unit time. Then the average speed also you have done total distance by total time. Is it? So this is, so now we can wind up this session, right? So